Hello, today's feature of the week video is about modeling categorical data. In this type of data, the observations for each individual eye at every time point take values in a fixed and finite set of categories. Categories can be binary, for example to describe if a patient responds or not to a therapy. These binary categories are a subset of nominal categories where several options are possible. Then if the categories are ordered, we call them ordinal. An example is pain level, which can be described as none, moderate, or severe. There is an increasing need of modeling categorical responses. It allows to analyze effects of potential predictors X on the response variable Y, and then use this model to simulate new scenarios. But modeling of categorical data is not simple and requires both mathematical understanding as well as medical background. This video is going to be theoretical. You will learn from it about typical models for categorical data and how to implement them in the Mlxtran language. In the future videos, we will show practical examples and explain how to develop categorical models in Monolix, how to analyze the goodness of it, and how to interpret the results. So let's start with a short reminder how categorical data are encoded in Monolix. The categories in the observation column must be consecutive integers, for example 0, 1 for binary or 1 to 3. It is possible to have longitudinal categorical data with several time points per ID or not, but if there is only one value, we need to add a single time point for each ID, for example at 0. Finally, after loading a categorical data set in Monolix, we need to change the type of data from continuous to categorical count. If this type of data is new to you, check our feature of the week video number 50 for a detailed description about the encoding and visualization. Now let's look at typical models used for categorical data. They depend on the type of categories, and binary categories are the easiest ones, so we will start with this group. So let Y be a response variable and X an explanatory variable. X can be a covariate such as age or sex, time, drug concentration, or any other predictor. If Y would be a continuous variable, then the simplest relationship between Y and X is linear, so alpha plus beta times X. The parameter alpha is the intercept and beta describes the strength of the effect of X on Y, and it is sometimes called a slope. But if Y is a categorical variable, then this model is not appropriate. It gives a continuum of values y for each x instead of 0, 1 for example, binary data. So for categorical responses, instead of modeling y directly, we model the probability that y takes a certain value, for example, 1, knowing that the explanatory variable has a value x. And we can write it like this. Having only two possible answers, the probability to have the second answer is 1 minus p. And an important notion in the modeling of probabilities is the odds ratio. It is the ratio of the probability that an event occurs versus probability that it does not occur. As it takes only positive values, it is convenient to define the logarithm of it, which is defined from minus to plus infinity. The logarithm of p over 1 minus p is called logit of p. Now, recalling the linear model for continuous variables, we can define the linear model that relates the logit of p and the explanatory variable x. Parameter alpha is the intercept, as for the linear regression, and describes the value of the logit of p when x is equal to 0, and beta describes a change of the logit associated with a change in x. Now, rewriting this equation, we get the formula for the probability p itself. This is the well-known logistic function, and this model is called logistic regression. Before we move to the case with several covariates, let's look closer at the difference between the odds ratio and the probability. If the probability that the response y is equal to 1 is 0.1, then the odds to have 1 are 1 to 9. If the probability is 0.5, then the odds are 1. And when the probability is 0.9, the odds are 9. So you can see that the increase of odds depends on the original probability. And as you can see in this plot, the odds become extremely large when probability approaches 1. Binomial categories data with only two options we have just seen is actually a special case of nominal categories. We can have a data with several categories that describe different choices or different outcomes. For example, in an analysis of the effects of a long-term cancer treatment, categorical data could describe causes of death. 1 means a patient is alive, 2 corresponds to a death from the cancer that has been treated, 3 from another cancer, and 4 means death for another reason than cancer. Modeling in this case may be useful to test if the exposure to the treatment is a significant predictor of the cause of death. In this case, a common approach is to apply the binary strategy where we compare each category versus a reference one. So suppose that there are k plus 1 categories and we want to model the probability that a response variable y equals to one of these categories. And now let the category k plus 1 be the reference category. The odds ratio can be defined for each category up to k with respect to this reference 1 k plus 1. It is often known as the relative risk of one category compared to the reference one. Now we can follow the same approach as for the binary data. So calculate the logarithm of the odds and assume the linear relationship between it and the explanatory variable. This is an example of a generalized logistic regression, and it has the advantage to ensure that the probabilities of all categories sum up to 1. This model has k equations and 2k parameters because in general, separate alpha and beta corresponds to different categories. This type of model can be useful in testing the effects of predictors simultaneously on all response categories. But looking at the number of parameters, the dataset needs to be rich enough to allow reliable parameter estimation. However, in clinical trials, we often deal with several categories with a special property. They are ordered. For example, pain level can be described as low, medium, or strong, or patient health status can be described in a scale from 1 to 5, with 5 completely healthy, or treatment efficacy can be poor, fair, good, or very good. In this case, it is easier and more convenient to define a model using the cumulative probability, which takes into account the order of categories. So for each category I, the cumulative probability is a probability that a categorical response is equal or is lower than the category. The advantage of this approach is that we can define the odds of being below a certain level versus being above a certain level. And it is like a cumulative binary situation. Now the ordinal logistic regression is the linear model applied to the logit of these cumulative probabilities. Parameters alpha in this model are thresholds for each category level in the absence of the other effects modeled by X and are specific for each category. In addition, they have to satisfy the following condition. It is a direct consequence of the fact that logit is a monotone function and categories are ordered. So probability to have, for example, pain level poor or fair is always lower than probability to feel poor, fair, or moderate pain. To simplify this model, a very common approach is to use the proportional odds model. It assumes that the effects of the explanatory variable is the same for all categories. In other words, the beta parameters are the same for each category, so beta I equals to beta. Now let's look at how to implement models for categorical data in Mlxtran. It has to be done in the definition section of the structural model and has a specific structure. First, with the option type, we say that the model is categorical and not count or time to event. Then we define the list of all categories used in the dataset loaded in Monolix. And finally, we define probabilities for n-1 categories. The last category is defined implicitly from the assumption that the probabilities for all categories sum to 1. For the estimation of model parameters, it is more convenient to work with values from minus to plus infinity, so we can use the logit directly in the model. Similarly, if categories are ordered, we can use the cumulative probabilities in the definition. Let's see a few examples, starting from the binary data with categories 0 and 1. We define here the logit of the probability that a response takes one of the values, for example 1. As for continuous models, parameters used in the model will be estimated if they are listed in the input line. The probability can depend on time, and remember that t is a keyword in Mlxtran for time. It can also depend on regressor values that are taken from the dataset, or on the drug concentration in a joint PK categorical models. For clarity, you can also write the formulas in the equation block outside the definition block. We use logit because it takes values from minus infinity to plus infinity. It is convenient in the estimation, but it is also possible to define the probability directly, for example, using the logistic function. Now, if I have three categories with no sense of direction, we need to define two probabilities. The third one is defined implicitly, as was already explained. By the way, you can see that the name of the variable is free and it appears here, here, and here. The formulas contain individual parameters specific for each category, so alpha 1 and alpha 2 for intercepts and beta 1 and beta 2 for the effect of time. If the categories are ordered, we use the cumulative probabilities and model the probability that the response is equal or below a certain level. The intercepts have to satisfy the ordering condition, so it is convenient to define them in this way, with alpha and alpha plus gamma. Here, the beta parameters are specific for each level, but they can also be equal if the proportional odds assumption is valid. Do not forget to use the Mlx editor application to write Mlxtran models. The syntax check will help you to verify if everything is correct before loading the model in Monolix. Thank you for listening and have a good weekend.